Hey everyone, I'm Hollander Cooper.
Hey, and it's Zach Betka.
And I've beaten Pokemon X and Y.
And I haven't, so I have some questions about it.
All right, let's hear them.
So, totally new 3D world.
Yes.
How does that look?
It looks great. Pokemon has never really been all that visually ambitious. I mean, they've stayed 2D for six generations worth of game. And this one, the cool thing is that it's not only in 3D in terms of the style and the fact that the world's in 3D, but the game does not make any... doesn't have any problem like dropping the camera down for behind the back in some scenes, moving the camera around a lot. They messed a little bit with that in Black and White, but in this game, it's like it's a real 3D game. The camera is still usually pulled up behind you, but it's not like they rendered it in 3D and then recreated the visual look of the old games. It is a cool-looking 3D game, and the battles also are all 3D, and they look super cool.
Well, speaking of the battles, you had to take all the Pokemon and render them in 3D.
Yeah.
So how do the new Pokemon look? How do the old Pokemon look now in 3D?
They look good. So, I mean, every so often you'll get, like, an old Pokemon that looks kind of weird, but, I mean, Nintendo's been doing this for a while. Game Freak's been doing this for a while. Like, the Pokemon Colosseum games have been rendering them in 3D, so they know what they're supposed to look like, and this game does a good job of realizing them. And the new Pokemon look cool. All the starters look cool. Some of the legendaries look cool. They all have a nice style to them. I'd say that it's probably, I mean, they didn't add as many, I don't think, as they added in Black and White 2, so they didn't need to stretch themselves as thin when thinking of concepts.
Uh-huh.
It's not like they're like, well, we need a new bat. Like, so a lot of the new Pokemon are genuinely cool looking.
Okay, well, they added Mega Evolutions.
Yes.
So they did add to do more design that way.
Yeah, and the Mega Evolutions look really cool, though I will say that that's one of the elements that was kind of disappointing for me.
Really?
Mega Evolutions, it's like, I mean, I could be wrong on this so far because they don't really totally explain what they do.
Mm-hmm.
They make your Pokemon stronger, probably. That's sort of the assumption, but they don't get new moves or anything, which is fine, but it's almost like there's no reason, if you can Mega Evolve a Pokemon in a battle, there's just no reason ever not to. There's not some weird risk-reward thing. The only thing that it prevents you from doing is Mega Evolving another Pokemon in that battle.
Okay.
So it's I don't know, I was kind of expecting there to be some kind of, like, really cool mechanic behind it, when in reality it's like, all right, start the battle, this guy can Mega Evolve, click Mega Evolve, let's just do it.
Well, are there any other changes to gameplay that struck you?
A bunch of little ones, like little things that I think fans are going to really like EXP share has been redone, where it used to be one Pokemon has it, and then it, like, shares experience with another one.
Mm-hmm.
Now, EXP share is the Pokemon who fought in the battle gets half of the experience, and the rest just gets given to the rest of your party, which actually makes a huge difference in the game because it doesn't mean you have to kind of strategically level one up at a time.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the way this scaling works with experience, it just kind of keeps all of your Pokemon leveled.
Awesome.
all time. So if you go get a new Pokemon or whatever, they'll all be within a certain level range, which actually sort of fixes one of the big problems that I didn't even realize I had with Pokemon, which is that, I have a new level 5, one guy's level 20, and one guy's level 30. I gotta kind of strategically do all this stuff, and it kind of feels weird.
Okay, so how about the story? Because we had a pretty deep story in Black and White. Is it translated?
Yeah, it's light for most. It has its moments. I don't want to spoil anything, but a majority of the game is just what it looks like. You set off on an adventure with a bunch of friends to find out about Mega Evolutions and fill up that Pokedex, and it's just sort of charming in how light it is. It gets deeper, it gets cooler, but it's almost like a palate cleanser for how deep and dark Black and White got.
Uh-huh.
But it ends up going some places you may not expect, I'll say.
Okay. Well, you talked about friends, so there's not just, like, a rival, and that's it. You have, like, five friends? And
yeah, only one of them is your, like, self-proclaimed, I am your rival kind of thing. But a majority of them are just peripheral characters that show up to dispense exposition, and then they dash away.
Okay. So are there any minigames in this one?
Yeah, but they're actually kind of important because they're linked to the Pokemon Ami thing, which is on the bottom screen. You can, like, pet your Pokemon and stuff,
that's
which
nice.
At first I thought was going to be dumb and pointless, but it's actually really, really important because it finally fulfills the idea that if your Pokemon are friends with you, they perform better. So you can level up their affection, you'll pet your Pokemon, you'll play minigames with them, you'll feed them, and the higher their affection gets, the better they actually perform in battle. which is a huge deal.
Yeah.
It doesn't translate to multiplayer as far as I can tell, but in the single player, you'll have Pokemon that are just like, oh, somebody used a sleep move on your Pokemon, but they don't want to make you sad, so they just don't fall asleep. Like, crazy things like that. And they also took EV training, not EV, but EV training, like the effort value training, and made it into an actual mechanic with minigames, so you can... anyone can get into that weird, complex world of Pokemon that you normally need to read spreadsheets to understand.
Cool, okay. So last question, does it still feel like a Pokemon game?
It really does. It takes a little while to get there. It meanders, especially with that whole thing where you have five friends. Your friend gives you one starter, and then the professor gives you a red-blue starter, and it's kind of weird at first, and it feels kind of mishmash, but eventually it gets into that good comfort zone that Pokemon fans are looking forward to and looking forward to spending like 150 hours just, I guess, catching them all. Is that what I should say here?
Gotta.
Yeah, I gotta. I just gotta. Everyone's gotta.
So what score did you go with?
See, I ended up going with a 4 out of 5. It's really good, but especially with everything visually evolving so much, it lets you know that some other elements of the game probably need to start evolving as well. The story could be a little better. There are some mechanics that feel like they've been there since the beginning, but it's time for some minor changes to make them easier to use. So yeah, went with a 4 out of 5.
Okay.
Yeah, and you can check out more reasons why and my full text review on GamesRadar.com.